آمين. الحمد للحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. نبدأ إن شاء الله تعالى حديثنا عن تميم الداعي. And we start إن شاء الله تعالى our journey with the Sahabi, the scholar and companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Tamim al-Dari. من لتحقيق الاسم يشار إليه بتميم الديري بالياء وتميم الداري بالألف. عند يحيى ابن يحيى الليثي الذي روى الموطأ عن مالك، فيشار إليه بيحيى أبي تميم الديري نسبة إلى الدير، والدير هو كنيسة النصارى. There are two references in regards to his name, the name of Tamim al-Dari. Tamim is his name. His kunya is Abu Ruqayya. His eldest daughter is Ruqayya. He's nicknamed after, or his kunya is taken after his oldest daughter, Ruqayya. So he is Abu Ruqayya. Tamim is his first name. Al-Dari, نسبة إلى بني الدار. Daddy, as if you were to say Pennsylvanians, Americans, Moroccan, it is reference to his clan. The clan is the clan of Banu Ad-Dar. This is what you will find in reference to his clan. This is where he comes from. And Banu Ad-Dar is an offshoot of the tribe of Lakhm. وهي هذه فرع من قبيلة لخم، ولخم هذه التي حرف اسمها إلى لحم. فالآن بفلسطين منطقة تسمى ببيت لحم، وإنما هي أصلها هي بيت لخم، هي نسبة إلى اللخميين. It is an offshoot of Ya'rub al-Qahtani, which is, it goes back to the original Arabs of Qahtan that are offshoot from the original Arab al-Arab al-Arib al-Asli al-Qahtaniyin. And then they are originally from al-Yemen. فنزحوا اليمن طبعا لها تاريخ عظيم جدا. The history of Yemen is tremendous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made reference to مملكة سبأ, the dynasty of Sabaeans, Sabaeen, and the queen of Sheba with Sulaiman alayhi salam. It's a long history that is way rooted in that area of Yemen. And it is expanded also. It stretches the dynasty of Al-Yemen. It stretches across the water to what is known as what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would later send the Sahaba to, and that is Al-Habasha. Al-Habasha, back at the time, it is part of the dynasty that stretches across the water into Al-Yemen, which is the south of the Arabian Peninsula, إلى جنوب الجزيرة. And Al-Habasha at the time consists, just like back then, whenever there is reference to Al-Sham, Al-Sham is what is to us now as Syria, Lebanon, Palestine and Jordan, all four different countries. Back then, it is one territory and it is referred to as a Sham. The same thing. Whenever you hear in the Sira, يعني سبحان الله كلما تذكر الحبشة في السيرة وفي التاريخ، فالحبشة آنذاك إمبراطورية عظيمة وأرضها واسعة وتضم الدول الحالية الآن اللي هي الصومال، إريثريا، جيبوتي، وأثيوبيا. هذه الدول الأربع. And it involves all of these four countries that are now small countries. Somalia, Eritrea, Djibouti, and Ethiopia. Those all used to be referred to as one territory as Al-Habasha. And that's where the Prophet ﷺ originally sent the Sahaba when they were oppressed in Mecca. Nonetheless, this is where يعني جنوب الجزيرة, اليمن, that's where the home and the clan is originated from, meaning the root of this tremendous man. And it is well worth it for us to know the roots of all of this about a man who would introduce such a knowledge and such a reality that the Prophet ﷺ would even honor Tamim al-Dari by narrating a hadith of his. This is Rasulullah narrating a hadith of Tamim al-Dari. And never did he, عليه الصلاة والسلام, narrate a hadith about any of the Sahaba except for him, رضي الله تعالى عنه وأرضاه. تميم الداري, his clan, يعني قومه نزحوا من اليمن بعد خراب سد مأرب. See, السبائيين كانت لهم, سبحان الله, كما ذكرهم رب العزة, آية فيهم آية. They were tremendous as a civilization. So they were good at even building dams. SubhanAllah. Back at the time, one of the greatest dams, يعني من أعظم السدود في التاريخ, هذا سد مأرب, مدينة مأرب. وسبحان الله, لكن بعد خراب السد نزح المنطقة, أصيبت بمجاعة وقحط. فنزح أهلها إلى الشام. يعني right after the destruction of the dam, obviously drought and poverty and sickness started spreading. So people moved up north, and then all of them ended up in the Great Syria area. فجزء منهم استقروا بسوريا الآن, محلها الآن سوريا. ومنهم من استقر بهضبة الجولان, ومنهم من استقر بفلسطين. فنزحوا, you know, so his people, the clan, moved from Yemen due to the drought historically, and some of them settled in what is known as Syria, and some of them in هضبة الجولان, known as the Golden Height. The Golden Height now, part of it is at the time is Assyrian territory that Israel in 1967 took over, and it is still a fight over that territory to this day. And it is always a place of contention politically and militarily, and every now and then you will see that confrontation that you hear Golden Height and you have no idea what that is. And this is a territory that belongs to the Syrians. And the point, some of his people settled in. As for Tamim al-Dari's family, they settled in Palestine. And being بحكم أن هذه الأراضي هي أراضي الرومان, والدين في عند الروم هي النصرانية. At the time, the land is the Roman territory. And obviously the religion is Christianity. فمن قومه من تنصر, تأثروا بالنصرانية فتنصروا, ومنهم كذلك تميم الداري تنصر. لكن أصلهم أن اللغميين كانوا يعبدون الكواكب, وخاصة كوكب المشترى أو المشتري, كانوا يعبدون الكواكب. فقبيلة لخم هذه اليمنية, when they moved up to Syria, they used to worship the stars. يعني يعبدون الكواكب, especially Jupiter. They used to worship Jupiter as one of, as they consider that as the god in charge of the sky. سبحان الله, هذا اعتقادهم. فكان يسمونه بإله السماء, وإله بحكم أنه أكبر حجما وضياءا, فكانوا يعبدون الكواكب. فمنهم من ضل على اعتقادي أو التدين بعبادة الكواكب, ومنهم من تنصر. Some of them they remained on the worship of the stars, and some of them they became Christian. تميم الداري became Christian. This is how, when you look at his biography, they usually jump straight into saying, well, he was a Christian and he became a Muslim. Subhanallah. لكن تميم الداري هذا, Subhanallah, with his family, he focused with knowledge, literally, and he went further in Christianity so far that he became a priest himself. فأصبح راهبا من رهبان النصارى, يعني بلغ مراتب في التدين بالنصرانية. As he was doing one of his trips, just like we all do, subhanallah, when it comes to da'wah, you know, and then he travels to teach. As he was taking one of his journeys to an area, and he overnight ended up in a valley, in an area that was so dark. And he says, فأصابني هلع وخوف, نزل بوادي مظلم. فكان من طبع اليمنيين باعتقادهم أنهم إذا نزلوا واديا يعتقدون أن ملكا من ملوك الجن يملك الوادي فيستجيرون به. يقول أستجير بملك هذا الوادي حتى يحميهم. يعني سبحان الله, وأنه كان رجال من الإنس يعوذون برجال من الجن فزادوهم رهقا, فكانوا يستجيرون بهم من الجن. And traditionally back in Yemen, they had the tradition that every time they travel through an area, they believe that every area is owned by a king and a kingdom and a clan from jinn. And usually when you come into an area, you seek refuge and the protection of the king of that valley. So they used to say, whenever they land in an area, they say, we seek refuge with the king, meaning the king, jinn king from this valley, in this valley. سبحان الله, قال هذا تميم الداري, قال فسمعت مناديا يناديني استجر بالله ولا تستجر بجن فإن الجن لا يقدرون على من استجار بالله. شو سبحان الله. And he says, and I heard a voice as clear as can be speaking to me saying, seek refuge in Allah instead. He says, no jinn would dare to harm anyone who seek refuge in Allah. He says, seek refuge in Allah instead. Don't seek it. And he says, we have become Muslim. The last of the prophet had already come out, and he is in Mecca, and he's headed to Medina. He says, subhanAllah, too. تميم الداري. فأخبره أن آخر الأنبياء وخاتم الأنبياء قد خرج بمكة وهو في طريقه إلى المدينة, يعني مهاجرا صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. And he says, that's the person you need to go and meet with. He says, and سبحان الله, يعني فيه إشارة إلى الجن الذين أسلموا مع النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. فكان هذا منهم الذي دل تميم الداري على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على الإسلام. من العجائب سبحان الله, وأن الإنسان إذا قصد رب العالمين بصدق هي الله له أسباب الخلاص والهداية والرشد. And سبحان الله, whenever you set your sincere intention towards Allah, this is all what Allah Ta'ala wants to see. Everything else Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala will put in line and keep things rolling for you. You feel like you're not doing anything at all. Everything is done for you, subhanAllah. The point, he says, فَهَذَا أَرَوْعِي. After he spoke, what I heard that, and I said, فَقُلْتُ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ أَسْتَجِيرُ بِاللَّهِ. He says, I seek refuge in Allah. He says, the minute I said it, I felt so calm and the fear disappeared, subhanAllah, he says. He says, فَقَصَدْتُ رَهْبَانَ أَوْ رَاهِبَ الدَّيْرِ. He says, and I went straight to the priest of the monastery that I was headed to, the closest one to me. Just like if you wanted to pray, you look up the closest masjid and you go and pray. And he says, فَقَصَدْتُ رَاهِبَ الدَّيْرِ, the closest monastery. I went and I spoke to that priest immediately. And I told him about the experience of the night before. And he says, both of them said, وَكَانَ رَجُلًا رَجُلًا صَالِحًا فَقَالَ لَهُ إِنَّكَ تَرَى مِنْ حَالِ مَا تَرَى لَا أَسْتَطِيعُ الرَّحِيلَ إِلَى هَذَا النَّبِيِّ وَلَوْ اسْتَطَعْتُ لَفَعَلْتُ. He says to him, you know and I know, here's the scripture that speaks about the last of the prophets to come out. And you look at my situation. I'm old and weak. I can't travel. But if you can, you should. And you know that he is the last of the prophets. If you can do it, don't let anybody else to beat you to meet with him. Rush and do it. Ashub subhanAllah. فخرج تميم الداري مع أخيه نعيم الداري. And then with his brother, they set their journey on their journey, and then they left for Medina. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at the time had just finished the battle of Al-Yarmouk, which is in the ninth year. فرجع قافلا عليه الصلاة والسلام فلقيه تميم الداري بالمدينة. And you're talking about a journey, quite a journey, although it's not as far as Mecca or Yemen, because Medina sits geographically north of the peninsula. يعني المدينة نسبيا قريبة من الشام. فنزل إلى يعني نزل بالمدينة ولقي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأسلم. شو سبحان الله, فقال للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني تميم الداري came to Medina, met with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, long story short, and then he embraces Islam. And part of the things that he asked the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he told him, يا رسول الله, فقال له يا رسول الله, إن فتح الله تعالى على المسلمين أرض الشام اقتطع لي. He said to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا رسول الله, when هذه فراسة من تميم الداري, سبحان الله, فراسة, it's an intuition. He says, when, as if he already knows that Islam is going to go all the way up to الشام, فراسة منه. فقال له يا رسول الله, إن فتح الله بلاد الشام للإسلام فاقتطع لي ولأهلي فأهلي. He said that my family resided in this area. وهي ما تعرف بمنطقة حبرون, جنوب القدس. وهي ما تعرف بمدينة الخليل الآن. مدينة الخليل هذه منطقة تميم الداري. فاقتطعها النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم لتميم الداري. قال هذه أرض أهلي. فاقتطع لي هذه. فقال له يا رسول الله اكتب لي بها كتابا. He says, يا رسول الله, My family lives in this area. Should Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the land of Asham to al-Islam, write for me that this land is mine for me and for my people. For the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala fa'alt. I will do that. He says, Ya Rasulullah, would you record it for me? Would you record it for me with witnesses? And he did, alayhi salatu wasalam. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, طبعاً لا يكتب ولا يقرأ, لكنه طلب فكتب هذا لتميم الداري. طبعاً هذا الكلام هذا يعني لم تفتح أرض فلسطين وتسلم مفاتيح القدس إلا على عهد عمر بن الخطاب. Of course, عمر بن الخطاب is actually, you're looking at the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, his death, and then you're looking at Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, his time was over, and then عمر بن الخطاب. It is during the time of عمر بن الخطاب that the keys to Jerusalem were given to the to عمر بن الخطاب بعد أن فتحها عمر بن العاص. سبحان الله. الشاهد من هذا أن تميم الداري كانت له أرض مقتطعة وكتبها له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, وكانت هذه من فراسة. This is one of those intuitions that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, اتقوا فراسة المؤمن فإنها لا تخطئ. He says you can bank on the intuition of a believer because it does not miss. It is always on point. We say that this is my gut feeling. Or what's that gut feeling? هذا نور من الله. This is what a nur of the divine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspires the sincere and clear hearts. Not everyone who claims I am a believer will get that, but rather it is when a person reaches a level of sincerity with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and that spiritual status, to where a person becomes literally with so many decisions that are not clean cut, would fall back on his intuitions. And he says, in that case, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you can bank on that intuition because it is on point always, because it is inspired by the divine himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَاتَّقُوا فِرَاسَةَ الْمُؤْمِنِ فَإِنَّهَا لَا تُخْطِئُ. فشوف سبحان الله, هذه كانت من فراسات تميم الداري. تميم الداري طبعا يعني بعجالة إن شاء الله تعالى وأختم هذا. I'll close it right here. Many, many beautiful things about Tamim al-Dari. بعد وفاة عثمان بن عفان, هو لازم مكة, عفوا المدينة, استقر بالمدينة ولازمها, وكان من العباد, حفظ القرآن على عهد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قبل أن يتوفى, قبل أن يتوفى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. يعني وكان طبعا من طبعه أنه كان يتعبد في ديره, فهذا كان عنده تربية هذه عادية نقلها إلى الإسلام. فكان يختم القرآن كل سبع, every seven days, because of the discipline that he brought with him from the way he used to in his monastery, when he would spend hours and hours in the worship in the monastery. So that solitude, if you will, and it's something that he carried over with him, subhanallah, and he found that the Quran, subhanallah, he had quite the relationship with the book of Allah, to where he used to finish reading the Quran every 7 days. He would make a khatm every 7 days. فكان يختم كل سبع وكان من العباد فيعرف أنه من عباد الشام. He was known and he was heartbroken when, of course, after the death of Umar ibn al-Khattab, Uthman ibn Affan took over, but not for long, because the fitna of Uthman, and then he would be assassinated. And when that happened in Medina, he was heartbroken. وكانت له علاقة وطيدة بعثمان, كانت بينهما محبة. يعني Uthman and Tamim al-Dari, they used to be so close. They had quite the relationship of closeness and love to one another, subhanAllah. And that apple does not fall far from that tree, because Uthman ibn Affan himself used to finish the Quran sometimes. One night he would finish the whole Quran. يعني subhanAllah, الطيور على أشكالها تقع. You know, Birds of a feather flock together. So you can see just the common thread, one of the many common threads between Uthman and Tamim al-Dari, the Quran alone. Uthman ibn Affan used to finish the Quran one night. He would do qiyam from Isha to Fajr. Quran is done. And so they had quite the relationship. Uthman ibn Affan tuwfiya qutila wa huwa yaqra'u al-Quran. Uthman ibn Affan, he was assassinated while he was reading the Quran. Allahu Akbar. So he was heartbroken. فخرج إلى الشام واستقر بالشام وكان من عبادها. And that's where he sat there. فتوفي سنة 40 للهجرة. And then he died in the year. And to this day, there is a temple actually that was built around his grave. Today say in Golden Heights بهضبة الجولان وقيل أنه دفن بأرضه اللي هي بفلسطين يعني بالقدس لكن رحم الله تميم الداري ولنا إن شاء الله تعالى وقفات مع تميم الداري إن شاء الله سبحانه وتعالى نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعلمنا وإياكم من أمر ديننا ما جهلنا ويرزقنا وإياكم الأدب بما علمنا وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد والحمد لله رب العالمين جزاكم الله خير السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته